Hey guys, it's DukeOnRed1 and welcome to episode 34 of Let's Build Castle Krine. There has been a lot of changes in the past 2 weeks, and I mean a lot. I was tired of making the small little changes here and there that I thought would help Krine, but it just, time and time again, it just never worked out for me. So I just decided we're going to completely start fresh, but we are going to remove a lot of Krine, and we are going to rebuild a lot of Krine. And that is exactly what we did. So that is seems to be a tradition. Each episode, things keep changing. And I think that's the novelty of this series, is seeing new ideas each episode, something that you have not seen before, something that brings you back, and like you're so excited, you're like, holy cow, what has Dukan changed today? So that is what we've done this episode, and you know, since last episode. And I think that we are really going places now with Krine because of these changes that we have made. And I love it. So we have, we've done a lot. We're not done with this portion yet over here. There's still a lot that we gotta do over here. As you can see, we have basically removed that whole building. We removed all of that massive cathedral building. That is all gone. I removed it because I did not like it. Go figure. So we've replaced it with buildings, as you can see right here, which I think really make the castle look so much better. And we've separated the castle into four parts. So the first part is all of this down here. This is the stables. I don't even know why there's a feast hall here, but there's a feast hall there. Probably guest quarters. This is probably where lower guests, maybe servants would live. I don't know. We'll figure that out at some point. Maybe you guys can give me suggestions for what these buildings can be. So like obviously the gatehouse, there would be guards living in there. Not sure what would be in here. So there's these two buildings. There's this building here, and then there's this building right here. Who would live in these buildings? What would be in these buildings? I know the bottom levels of this building is going to be stables. There's going to be like two stories of stables, but it's not going to be accessible from the other side. The only way to get to the stables on the back side is you got to go through this gate right here, and then you got to come around and then go inside here, and it's going to separate into a bunch of stables. But above, I'm guessing since it's stables underneath, it probably should be servants' quarters above. So we'll figure that out. And then of course we got a massive feast hall right here. Lots of work we need to do in there, but that'll all come in time. As you can see, we've changed this area up here. We've removed a bunch of stuff that was there, and we've replaced it with that covered parapets or covered ramparts right there. I really like how that turned out. Also, this tower with that little bit of brick at the top, that really emboldens that area. That really just makes that so much more defined. I really like that. Also, that little balcony in the middle. Things like that just really have made this build look so much better. I'm so happy with it. Anyways, you come through here, through the gatehouse, it leads into the stables. This is all gonna be stables in here. The blacksmith to take care of all the like horseshoes and minor work for Krine would be in here. All of this building is gonna be for the blacksmith. Like this will probably be where he lives up here. Like all of this area is where he lives. Up in that area, but then his like work area will be underneath. So we have outside, we have 26. We have 26 stalls where horses can be, and I want there to be 24 more inside. So all of there's going to be 24 stables in here. I want there to be a total of 50 stalls, 50 horse stalls for 50 horses for Krine. So that's that idea. Anyways, you come in through here. This leads up to the main, or not the main gate, but the next portion of Krine. As you can see, there's a deep crevasse that separates the two sections of the castle. I really wanted to add this in because I was tired of everything just being connected. There needed to be more separation. And so there's only one bridge to get in between the two sides right here. So there's only that one bridge. Now, we probably will make like a secret, like another way to get down, say over here on the cliff, but it'll be like a really small way to get down and out. We'll figure that out when the time comes. Like maybe it'll go through the water and like maybe during low tide, it would open up the road to go through the water or something. We'll figure that out later on. So anyways, back to where we were. You come in through the gate to the left. I'm not sure what that building's going to be. This is the Scholar's Tower right here. This is where the scholars and like the lords of the castle, or not the lords of the castle, but yeah, the scholars would live in here in that tower. This is all barracks, so soldiers would live all in this part right here. This will probably be a guest building here. I'm guessing that'll be probably guests. Maybe even the priests would live in there, because this here is the chapel. This is a pretty, it's not very big actually. I mean, it looks big from the outside, but it's really not that big. On the inside, it's pretty small. We have a temple to a shrine to Xanthos, the king of, or the god of gods in my lore. Xanthos is like the equivalent of Zeus in Greek mythology. So this is the military courtyard. This is where all the guards and like the lord, this is where they would marshal and such. I'm probably going to make another wall right here in a little archway or something. Maybe make it diagonal. That could actually look pretty nice. But anyways, you come in through the drawbridge right here, and it leads right inside. You go left, and then you're into the courtyard. I'm not sure what this building will be. If you guys have ideas for this building and the second portion and the military area, let me know in the description or in the comments below. I would like to know what you guys think this should be. It's a pretty large building. It's set in the military quarter. But again, this is the Scholar's Tower, so maybe we could do something of a library in here. But the thing is, we did move it, so we could actually put some pretty big windows on this side. We still got to carve it out and such, but yeah, there could be windows there. That it could be a library. Could be. We'll see. But yeah, if you have any ideas, let me know. Not sure what this is going to be. Some suggested like a food storehouse. I think I like that idea. But anyways, you come up through here. This leads up to the next section. So if you go right, it leads to the palace. If you go left, it leads to the courtyards over there, where all the like the trees and greenery and just nice, pristine, beautiful stuff will be. The castle blacksmith, like the one that makes the weapons and everything, will be at the lower part there, or in the lower part there. So you lead up, this leads up to the palace. You go through a barbican here, and then you go through this. You got another drawbridge, and it leads to another barbican. And then you go into this portion of the castle where there's like a, it's like this is all going to be one big building, and there's going to be like a tunnel through it that makes a 90 degree angle, so you can't get like battery rams in here. And then it leads right into here, and this is going to be the palace courtyards in here. This is where all the greenery will be. This is where all the happy people will be, or not the happy people, but at least the people that are very well to do are going to be. The general layout is this right here. I'm not quite sure what each of the buildings are going to be, but we'll figure that out. A lot of it's going to be royal residence and such like that. This right here is going to be the throne room, and also it's going to be the Patreon hall. For those of you that are our Patreons, I have two Patreons so far, but for those of you that are going to be Patreons in the future, or if you want to be a Patreon, your name will eventually go into this hall, and I actually might make this bigger. I think that it needs to be a little bit grander than what it is right now. I might expand it out a few blocks and then also push it this way a few more blocks, which I think might work out. So but yeah, this is going to be the throne room / Patreon hall at some point. This right here is the donjon. So you go across here, you have a drawbridge and another barbican, and then you gotta walk all the way around the path, around the outside of the donjon, and it leads inside the back. Now up here, there's like a little garden where people can do things like, you know, just like a little garden up here, flowers and such. There's gonna be drains that lead out of the castle so that, you know, don't get flooded in there, stuff like that. But I really like the symmetrical design of this. I really think it works. I like it. I love the look of that. So that is going to be the donjon / the last defense of Krine. But anyways, that is the overall idea of Crine so far. I really am happy with it, and I hope you guys like it as well. This crevice right here really has brought the build together. I mean, this has really changed Crine a lot. And I like this little, this is like a little arch right through here. I love that. We might add a few more arches like that around, so we'll see. We'll see. So anyways, what we're going to be working on in this video is right over here. We're going to be working on the gate. We're going to work on the exterior, not the interior. We're going to detail all of this. We're going to make all of this look pretty good. And then we're also going to work on that right there. And I think we're also going to work on the back and such. We're probably going to make just... we're probably going to be able to look at up at this, and it's all going to be relatively complete. So I'm hoping that we can get that done this video, and I think it'll hopefully turn out pretty good. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and get started, and let's see what we can come up with. So just be aware, we're going to be jumping all over the place. We're going to be going from down here to up there. We're going to be doing texturing. We're going to be doing building. It's going to go back and forth. So just try to hang with me as we're trying to build Crine. I removed those wood hoardings. I really wanted them there, but then I really didn't want them there. I just thought, see, wooden hoardings are usually only built onto a castle when there is a siege going on. But in this case, I just wanted to have those covered ramparts. Now, they change later on, so just keep that in mind. Right now, you're like, ooh, that does not look good, but we'll change that, and it'll hopefully look a little bit better. So we're changing some things. We're making the fortifications larger and such. So right here, see that where the angles connect? I wanted to put that little turret there to sort of blend the two together instead of just being this like flat face. It just didn't work. So down here, I'm making a guard booth or two guard booths where guards can maintain and maintain the entrance into the castle. This is where people would have to go through in order to get up to the castle, and they would basically say you can come in or you can't come in, stuff like that. And we add in like a little grated entrance down here. So this is like for peasants or something like that. Definitely not for like say during an attack. They would definitely not be down there like you can't come in while a whole army of enemies are coming down the causeway. That would not work. And we make like a little guard building there where like maybe a marshal would be to see everything that comes into the castle, just to make sure that all the stuff that is, you know, not contraband going out or in, etc. So we're starting to texture the gatehouse. I'm trying to figure out what I want to do with it. And it turns out really good. I really like how this turns out. But you'll also see that the double fortifications, it makes the fortifications look much stronger than what they were before, and I really like that. And we also have the two layers of fortifications, and I like how that worked. So we're adding in dormers to the roof of this gatehouse. Before, I did not like how it was just like a flat roof, so we add in the dormers, and I think that really helps define the roof a whole lot more. Now I add those really shabby buttresses on this side over here, but I was like, you know, later in the video, you're going to find out that those are not going to be there. This is going to change drastically on this side. And I'm looking forward for you guys to seeing that, because that is that's one of my favorite parts of the gatehouse now on that side. So we're adding in little fancy bits, little things. We're adding that tower. You know, the whole design of this tower is just sort of, you know, the two front turrets and everything, and then more or less a flat back. And as you can see, we connected the gatehouse to the feast hall with that one large building. But we're going around the back now. We're going to be working on the back a little bit. Now, this part that I'm working on right now, I'm probably not going to be using this later on. I'm not honestly quite sure. That little stairs down there, I don't really like how that looks. So we're probably going to be, even, you know, at the end of the video, I still don't like how that looks. So we're going to probably fix that up later on and figure out something different. But yeah, the backside, as you can see, we added in those larger windows at the top. Usually the smaller windows are at the bottom, and the larger windows of a building are at the top. The reason why that is the larger the window, the less support structure it needs, or the less support structure, or the more support structure it needs. There we go. I'm trying to, you know, not to twist my tongue while I'm trying to say that. But anyways, yeah, so bigger windows at the top of your buildings. Now we're adding in that red brick. Now this really changes Crine. Now the reason why I do this is the color of Crine is red and white. So I was like, you know, why don't we add in that sort of Polish Romanian sort of style of castle and add in that brick as the sort of like just little contrast areas around. And I think that really, really helps the build. And we'll be adding that brick throughout as well later on. And for sure, I think that it's going to look so much better than just like the white. The white just seemed to blend into the gray a little too much. But with the travertine and with the brick that we're using now, it really looks nice in my opinion. So now to the back, we're in the inner courtyard, we're working on little things, we had like a little porch down there. I wasn't quite sure what I wanted to do with it at first, we changed it several times, but in the end, I think it works what we do there. But the reason why I'm doing all this color is because we don't want it to be gray, and we don't want it to be shabby. You know, this is Crine, and Crine is supposed to be very, very defined and everything, and very, you know, looks like it's, you know, the architecture is very well done. So now this is my favorite part of, you know, the build right now is this network of buttresses on this side that lean into the other cliff. And I really like how they turned out because I really tried my best to work this out. So you'll see that each of the junctions lean on each other and each of the pillars lean on each other. Everything leans on each other. Otherwise, this whole thing would just kind of collapse in on itself. But see, everything leaning on each other, that's what's needed in order to make a proper network of flying buttresses. And so that is that right there. I really like how that turned out. And I think that really adds in a very unique feature to the side of the gatehouse. And some might say that it's a vulnerability, but you know, if they attack those buttresses, you know, there's not going to be really any way to get into Crine after that, because that whole canyon would be filled up and also the entrance would be blocked, etc. So there'd really be no way to get into the castle. So but anyways, yeah, I really like how that turned out. So now we're working on the inner courtyard again. I change up that balcony right there. I think that looks a little bit better than what it did before. We added in that little door on the top, etc. But now this is the final bit that we're going to be working on. Going to be adding in a lot of contrast in the courtyard. We're not going to finish up the courtyard today. We're only going to be adding in a few little details here and there just to get you the idea. We won't finish this courtyard up until we finish the other building, which will be in a future episode. So we'll see how that turns out. But yeah, with a new style and the new size of Crine, just makes sense to do little bits at a time. Well, especially with the replay mod, it makes it so much easier to do stuff like this instead of you know, little bits here and there, first person time lapses and setting up a camera, stuff like that. It just doesn't, you know, set, you know, it doesn't work as well, but the replay mod makes it so easy. But as you can see, I added that little turret back there with a little bit of tan, and we're adding in contrast value in the courtyard now. And we're adding like little bits of greenery. Greenery usually really, really helps. And so that's what we're doing. We're also adding those flower pots and things. I think that really helps define this courtyard a little bit better. And those like bushes that I have in the pots by the steps, those really work. And I really like the leveling of this, like the little steps that go up there. But yeah, last but not least, we're gonna be working on the gate here. This is going to be the we're going to have three portcullises and one swing gate. I think I might change it to two portcullises and two swing gates. I think that might turn out a lot better, or at least look a lot better. The reason why is because I just feel like there should be more swing gates in this, because it just feels like it feels a little dry to me without the extra swing gate. So we'll probably add that in a little bit later on and see how that turns out. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed and I learned some things throughout while we were building this, and I will see you guys soon. Well, there we are, guys. This is the new Grand Gatehouse of Crine. I really am happy with it. It looks so much more imposing than what we had before. What we had before just was really, it just seemed a little small for what I wanted to go for, and I really like how this worked, especially with these buttresses on the side here. The whole idea with this is that each of the junctions are supported, like lean on each other in order to support the greater whole, which is the side of that building right there. And it all leans into the rock face over there, as you can see. So, you know, and it wouldn't make sense to destroy that, because if you destroy that, then this whole thing, or not the whole thing, but the wall would collapse, and it would be more difficult for the invaders to get through, because this entrance is probably the only way into Crine right there. Speaking of which, I might make some walls, like, through the crevice to separate that so they can't, like, get boats in there or something if they want to attack through the crevasse. But anyways, I really like the red. We really needed that contrast value, and it works. Why does it work? Because the colors of Crine are red and white anyways. We will be adding in some flags as well. Like, I'm thinking putting a flag probably on this balcony right here. Maybe a few, like, banners along the, not banners, like, not the default, the vanilla banners, but, like, you know, just, like, the block banners, like, we'd actually build the banners, coming down from that wall right there, and that would add in a lot of color. Same thing with the gate, we'll probably add in some banners here. We now have two tiers of fortifications. The only thing I'm kind of worried about is this drawbridge. It feels like this would be stuck up here. We'll try to figure something out for that later on. We may or may not. We'll figure that out as time goes on. But I do like that there's now the two layers of fortifications. I really like that. In fact, maybe I'll just bring these down a little bit. Like, maybe I'll bring them down to about here instead. Then there, that would make up for the two block leeway that we, actually that's four blocks, but still that would make up for that space, I think. But yeah, that is the gatehouse on the front side, and then of course we've already seen the buttresses. And again, the white, the travertine brick, that works so well. And it just looks so much thicker now, like it looks like it's an absolute, you know, monstrosity. We'll add in some red Tudor on this side, as you can see, all that white Tudor is going to be red Tudor, and then we're also going to make all that into red Tudor, and then we're also going to add a turret right there on the end, just like this one right here. The reason why I added this in, you'll see that it goes from an angle of 2x, so this is about a 25 degree angle right here, and then it goes to the sort of flat wall. The reason why I put that turret in is to pretty much, it's to blend the two angles together, and I think that worked out by putting that there. It really removed that sort of like flat, like it just looked flat, and that adds in a little bit of depth as well, and I really like that. But anyways, that's the front side. Not really too much else to see here. I guess we'll go through the gate. I put three portcullises. There wasn't room for four. Now the thing is I'm pretty sure I should add in more gates like this. Like, there should be another gate, like, there should technically be a swing gate between each portcullis. I might end up just having two portcullises and two swing gates. So one swing gate here and another swing gate right here. The reason why you would have swing gates is to, like, you know, so they can't see through the gate and see what's on the other side. And also, like, that means that guards can be, like, in here, like, boarding up the entrance, whereas enemies can shoot through the bars and the portcullis, and it would be more difficult. You'll see that we have arrow slits all the way along the inside. We have murder holes on the top that allows the defensive feature, another defensive feature of the castle, so I think what's going to end up happening is it's going to have a drawbridge, two portcullises, two swing gates, and then you are in the courtyard. I added two guard booths here. You can imagine there'd probably be two guards here. And this gate would probably open inwards, like this way, because if it would open outwards, then these would be covered up. So I'll have to figure out a way to show, or, you know, to demonstrate that this opens this way versus opening this way. So we will do that eventually. So this is the back side of the gate. I really like how this turned out. I don't like this with the wooden railings. I might redesign that at some point. We'll figure that out later. We have the 2x windows on the top, and of course the dormers on the top of the gatehouse. I really like how those turned out. I really thought that the roof needed some more variation and more something just to give it some more interest and or some more depth and such, and I think those windows really helped. So this is the view in here. I like that we added that little turret right there that'll function as a stair tower. The little balcony back here so that he can, you know, whoever's up here can look down at the courtyard and such. And that little bit of contrast right there really helps. That really helps define that area. And just that little bit of contrast, I think that really helps. The little bit of greenery, that again is another contrast value that really helps the build. And then we also added some of that red brick back here as well. And then we'll do this probably next video. We'll see. Probably, I don't even know what we're going to do next video. Probably by the Friday, we'll probably already have that all textured and done. So we'll figure that out. And then once we get all this done, we'll start adding detail to the courtyard and make that look really nice, hopefully. So, but yeah, that's the idea with this. And man, I like how those buttresses turned out. But yeah, so this is crying so far. And I really like the new color palette. I really like the red. I originally did not want the red, but like, say if I just had it right here, it would look really weird. But since I've used it throughout the build, we might even use it up there on that tower, and then we'll figure out other places for it. Like, maybe we'll use it, I don't know, we want to still keep the white Tudor. Like, I definitely want to keep that white Tudor, but I'm not sure about, maybe we'll change that there or something. We'll figure that out when the time comes. We'll add more red Tudor throughout the build. Like, maybe all of this up here will be red Tudor, stuff like that. We just want that red everywhere. Not everywhere, but, you know, in certain areas to make it look really nice, so. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something, and I hope that you are liking how crying is going. Some of you are saying, like, oh my goodness, this is so extreme. Why isn't it done yet? Or, what, Dukan, why did you have to change it again? But this is, I like it. I like it. And I'm pretty sure the majority of you are going to say you like this as well. You like the layout. You like the general idea of where Crine is going. It's going to take us a long time, but it's going to be worth it. In the end, it's going to be worth it if we keep up with it and continue building this monstrosity and making it into the thing that we are looking to make it into, the castle. So, yeah, that's that, guys. I will see you on the next one. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I definitely appreciate all three of those. The support for the channel is tremendous, and I really appreciate each one of you for watching and supporting these videos. Also, I would like for you to go over to Facebook and Twitter, if you have either of those, and follow me on either of those if you guys want to keep up with what I am doing. Also, I have a Twitch where I live stream. That's where we actually built all of this planning. We built over on Twitch, so if you want to watch me build the majority of Crine, that's where you're going to find me doing that. And also, all the live streams are here on YouTube. If you look for the live stream playlist here on YouTube, you can watch all of this on YouTube. So just look for my live stream playlist on my main YouTube page. It's about three playlists down, and you can go ahead and watch my latest video of Crine, or my latest stream of Crine. So it's past broadcast, but whatever. And so, yep, that's about it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next one. Till then, bye-bye.